Howdy, kids. Dr. Freedom here with you. Sorry about the lighting and all that stuff on this video. I'm just kind of dropping in on you real quick because I got some stuff to throw at you before it gets too late in the evening. I got a little behind schedule today. I was going to try to pump this video out a little bit earlier, but, you know, the needs must, things going on. Like I said, it's a whole big hubbub. We'll talk about it later. All right. The thing I'm a little bit excited about for you folks over in the UK, you know, they're doing the Children in Need thing coming up. You can win a Doctor Who VIP tour. That is correct. They're offering one lucky winner their own VIP tour, the Doctor Who set in Cardiff, just as soon as it's safe to do so. You see, keep that in mind. This could be months from now that they finally, carve you in on this little deal if you do win it, all right? The winner will also get a personal video call from Doctor Who stars Jodie Whittaker and Mandip Gill and receive a host of exclusive Doctor Who merchandise, some of which is signed by the cast. Now, a lot of people are drawing attention to the fact that the only two names mentioned here are Jodie Whittaker and Mandip Gill. Makes you wonder, don't it, just what's going to happen next series. Just saying, I don't know. Okay, it's just kind of peculiar. All right, how to enter. Here's all the stuff you need to know. Remember, you do have to be a citizen of the UK. Otherwise, you know, they wouldn't be able to pull this off because the second you got over, you'd be in 2 weeks quarantine. And even then, as I said before, this, you know, is only going to be available, the set tour at least, when things have calmed down. Now, the prize draw for this will close for entries at 2 p.m. on Monday, the 23rd November, which is Doctor Who birthday, right there, baby, 23rd November. Please do not enter after this time as your entry will not count, but you will be still be charged for it. All right, the winner will be randomly selected, notified by phone on the 24th. So, wow, you know, they're going to go through this pretty quick. There's full terms and conditions and things like that you want to know. Now, here's the other thing hitting everybody pretty weird. Creative Casting is looking for a 5'5" white female with pixie cut blonde hair, or someone who's happy to have the hair cut and or colored, to play a double for an actress over the duration of the filming of a television show. And the filming on this starts on the 24th of November. Interesting, isn't it? Me, personally, I think there's already filming going on. We can't prove it whether there is or not. Like I said, it's just an instinct. I believe they are. Because this would be the perfect time to do it. When nobody suspects. All right, man. And you will be needed for multiple dates between January and mid-March. You'll need to have great availability as you'll be needed for lots of dates. There's been a strong hint running around that this is for Jodie Whittaker. Because one of the ways they can get around a lot of the COVID guidelines is some scenes like far-offs and, you know, doubling and all that. They can shemp and double and things like that if they have somebody available, you know, who can stand in for is what it is. So I think there's a lot of, you know, speculation that, yes, this is for Doctor Who. Kind of coincidental. 5'5", female, pixie cut blonde hair, Cardiff, starting the 24th of November. Okay. Exclusive, you can read an extract from quote-unquote, I Am the Master, Legends of the Renegade Time Lord. It is out now. So if you want to take a quick look at this, here you go. Bam, bam, bam. Here's a little overview of it. Your November fix of Doctor Who figurines. And out, coming out soon, is the Master. Check the outfit. And Queen of the Scythera. Who was played by Anzi Mohindra. Ooh, Masters of the Universe. Universe. And check the really cool stuff, man. Oh, man. So if you want to go check these out, they're over here on this site. Link will be below in the description box. Yes, I'll accept cookies from your website. Now kiss my butt. There you go. I hate those little prompts. All right, Eric Roberts plays Dr. Villain the Master in a live action for the first time in 24 years. This was just a little clip right here if you want to check it out. Just clicking on that right there. It's only about a minute so long, a little bit over a minute. Nice little teaser for all that. Now, wait, here we go. The Moffat shares his first draft script of the episode Blink. So, if you want to go check it out, apparently there was a different ending to the episode than what was put on the air. See, that's why I like reading the scripts, you know, when they get leaked out. It's not so I can know what's going on, but I like to see how an episode goes from the page to the screen. It's really an interesting process. All right, boom. And lastly, Steve Moffat, for some crazy reason, explains why the Paternoster Gang TV spinoff never happened. All right, here's the problem. And I've already explained this a billion times. For one, and I don't think he even covers this in this article. Three of your main cast would have to be in a makeup chair up to 2 hours before shooting every day, if not longer, depending on the prosthetics. Then, after all the shooting's done, they would have to be in a makeup chair for an hour to an hour and a half to remove all the stuff. That costs money. That costs people. Then you've got COVID guidelines, especially when you're applying prosthetics. Things along that line. But you know, even before that, prosthetics start to add up. You have a lot of big shows that have a lot of prosthetics, like Star Trek The Next Generation. Star Trek The Next Generation was actually considering doing a show that would have revolved around an entire Klingon crew. I'm blanking on the name. I want to say the Rotan was supposed to be the setting for that ship. It was a Klingon bird of prey. But the problem is, your entire cast would then have to be in and out of makeup chairs. You know, and that stuff adds up over time. It really does. On top of your special effects budget and whatnot. But this is his, you know, description as to why. But of course, we had the Paternoster Gang on Big Finish, so it's not all that bad. It's nice hearing from them every now and then, you know, especially in a good audio tale. Well, folks, that's all I had for you for today. So please take care of yourselves and each other. I'm getting out of here, so remember, COVID is still out there. Be careful. Take care of everybody. Have a good one. And hopefully we'll have a safe Thanksgiving. Oh, yeah, and that certain guy got kicked out of the White House. I really don't care. To me, it's just another ringmasters being brought into the big top with the usual assortment of clowns, geeks, and sideshow attractions. Another ringmaster will soon be in charge of the circus. That's all it is to me. All right, good night, everyone.